good cold too.
Mm-hmm. How many times you don't think sandwich?
That's right.
Pork
that's
loin,
right.
You think
so while
dinner.
They're slicing,
I think
let's
we did
talk
a good
about
job.
The topping.
This is what I did was I put a little bit of olive oil here, a little bit of bacon, and then I put spinach in it. Let the spinach tone down, and then we have some goat cheese here and crushed tomato that we're gonna make the sandwich with as soon as
great.
The guys
let's
are ready.
We're ready.
So
we're ready. We got some pieces.
Okay, thank you. This is great.
So what else should we do?
I need to slice this bread.
Oh, so you need our knife. Sorry.
Yeah, put the knife down.
Okay. Good job. Good job.
And while you're slicing there, Faz, you did mention that you also have a lamb sandwich. You can keep going.
Uh-huh.
So we're nearing time.
Yeah.
And fish tacos. So this is, and the pork sandwich you're making right now, is that on the menu?
Yes, it is. Uh-huh.
Great.
If you don't mind, I'm going to put the cheese down first.
Okay.
So it'll take a couple of slices of Swiss cheese right inside. And then what we're gonna do is have you put the
this
pork tenderloin
right
in there.
Yeah, oh, Beth, like a pro.
Yeah.
I like to pretend to be a chef on TV.
Smells so good.
Very good. And then what we can do here on the plate,
we are just about winding down, and as you're assembling, I want to start to say my thank yous. Joey, thank you so much for joining us and teaching Linda new phrases that we might have to now unteach her. Nate, always a pleasure to have you with us.
Glad to be back.
Yes, and Faz, thank you very much. Blue Mangrove Grill, make sure and enjoy the Suncoast view.
That looks good.
Mmm, smells good too.
At ABC7, our entire weathercast is dedicated to the Suncoast, and now we bring it to you like never before with the all-new official Suncoast forecast.
Beach and boating forecast. The winds will be out of the northwest at 10 knots.
Now, with the most advanced graphics and technology, we bring you weather where you live, pinpointing right down to your neighborhood.
Zooming into the Sarasota Bayfront,
the all-new official Suncoast forecast, only on ABC7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you. ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights.
A man on the Suncoast shares his favorite memories of working with the late music legend Prince. Governor Rick Scott stopping on the Suncoast to accept an award. And more construction, another bridge getting a facelift in Sarasota County. Your Suncoast News starts now.
Live from our studios on Florida's Suncoast. This is ABC 7 News at noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Hello and welcome. I'm Scott Dennis. Thanks so much for joining us. Topping our news today, an autopsy is underway on while many of us were shocked at the sudden passing of music superstar Prince. But it may take weeks before we learn what caused his death yesterday. Fans across the world are celebrating the singer's life, some dancing outside of the First Avenue nightclub in Minneapolis, the one featured in the movie Purple Rain. Others creating a memorial in front of his Minnesota studio and home. Here on the Suncoast, one resident was particularly saddened. Former Sarasota Housing Director Doug Logan says he was a music promoter back in the 80s and became friends with Prince. He describes Prince as a shrewd businessman, but also a soft-spoken and incredibly shy person.
I was fortunate to be invited to be his guest at his own club, Paisley Park in Minneapolis, and in a small room jamming with his friends. I remember walking out of Paisley Park a couple of times at 3:30 and 4 o'clock in the morning and just walking on air.
57-year-old Prince was found dead in an elevator at his studio compound in suburban Minneapolis. Florida's governor makes a stop in Sarasota last night and did not leave empty-handed.
We'd like to award you our 2016 Statesman of the Year.
Rick Scott receiving a bust of President Ronald Reagan after the Sarasota County Republican Party named him its Statesman of the Year. The private event at the Hyatt Sarasota is one of the local GOP's largest annual fundraisers. The award was given to Donald Trump for the second time last year. Governor Scott says he would have loved to have his mother and father there to share the experience.
She was so proud when we ran in 2010. She just couldn't imagine. She had a son that would ever get to run, even run for office, and even win being governor.
Meanwhile, outside the Hyatt, a group of protesters were protesting the possibility of another black bear hunt in Florida in an effort to maintain the bear population and limit the number of bear and human encounters. The state FWC last year approved the state's first black bear hunting season in about two decades. The FWC chairman recently directed staff and commissioners to prepare to discuss how another hunt could be managed if they decide to hold one. An academy that caters to children with autism and other disabilities is expanding now in Sarasota County. The ABA Academy opening a new facility in Sarasota. The new 5,000-square-foot building will be located right off Fruitville Road. It'll feature adjustable lighting to accommodate children with specific sensory issues and also color-coded walls to allow children to easily identify classrooms and associate specific classrooms with certain teachers. John Cavoli with Cavoli Engineering is working on the project. He has a son with autism, and he thinks this new facility will have a big impact on locals with autism and their families.
We look forward to ABA coming here locally to Sarasota and increasing the awareness of the autistic spectrum and addressing the needs of the community and helping parents like myself out because we have high hopes.
Academy staff say their current building on Braden Avenue is not the best option for their students, so this new academy is scheduled to open by this fall. It's going to go up quick. All right, let's get a check on our weather on this Friday. We're starting off the weekend with some clouds around.
Yes, huh? And a stickier feel to the air.
Yeah.
That's pretty obvious if you're walking around outside that humidity's back, it looks like. Yeah, we might be able to shave a few degrees off dew points over the weekend, but not much more than that. We're at the point now where the cold fronts coming through just don't mean much.
Right.
So today we'll see a wind shift that continues to bring us some very warm weather and some very humid weather as well. Punta Gorda webcam put into motion shows that time to time we had some clouds moving through, and now we're getting some building clouds as well that are kind of locally grown. You know, you can almost call them humid air clouds. They're the kind of clouds that we get in the summertime, these cumulus clouds that build on the sea breeze front. And that's probably where our showers are going to be for the most part this afternoon along the sea breeze front. They'll build inland, and then they'll move into sections of center Florida and toward the East Coast, further and further away from us as we progress through the evening hours. 82 degrees already, Sarasota, Bradenton, 80 in Venice, 83 degrees in Punta Gorda. And the daytime high today will feature about 85 degrees of daytime high, with some of those showers we see developing out in the Gulf, getting closer to shore, but the sea breeze showers being the main ones. We'll talk all about the forecast coming up in just a few. Scott.
All right, John, thank you. Lane closures are coming to one of the bridges to and from Siesta Key. Starting next week, FDOT will close one lane in a single direction daily from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. on the Stickney Point Bridge. The closures will continue for several weeks. The construction is part of a $5 million rehabilitation project on that span. A record number of baseball fans attending spring training games this year. Each game had an average of 7,996 spectators. Governor Rick Scott's office announced this is the first time that number has topped 7,000. More than 1.5 million fans overall attended spring training games in Florida. Scott says spring training and Major League Baseball games are a major attraction for visitors and have a huge economic impact in Florida. Suncoast roads filled with law officers this morning. Their job today, though, to help the athletes who compete in the Florida Special Olympics. The annual Special Olympics law enforcement torch run taking place. Sarasota County Sheriff's deputies running along U.S. 41 from Gulfgate Pavilion to the north. That torch was then passed off to the Sarasota Police Department in front of Paradise Plaza at 41 and B Ridge Road. The Special Olympics Summer Games happen next month in Orlando, where that torch will end its journey. ABC 7 business commentator Jeff Stern joins us now with a look at Wall Street. And this has been a big week for earnings, Jeff. How are the big companies looking so far?
For the most part, Scott, pretty well. And thanks for letting me know why I was late this morning. I was behind that group. Great cause for sure. Big companies, American Express, Verizon, General Motors yesterday, positive earnings looking strong. Unfortunately, the close of yesterday, two big giant tech companies, Google as well as Microsoft, were down, blaming the strong U.S. dollars. Good news is we're still positive for the year. So let's take a look how we're currently trading. The Dow Jones Industrial Average at 17,942, down 38 points, a quarter of 1%, while NASDAQ's trading at 4,880, down 65 points. That's 1.32% in the negative. S&P 2,083, it's down 8 points, just over a quarter of a percent.
Well, with the strong dollar, Jeff, you have some news, I understand, on McDonald's earnings.
McDonald's is doing well. Their numbers are strong. $6 billion for the first quarter. 1.1 of that is profits, up 35%. That's $1.23 per share. In a statement, McDonald's said brand and business is built on offering delicious food and beverage through unmatched convenience and value, and they hold true to that. They spent a lot of money last year on upgrades, turning around the company, and it seems to be paying off now. They offer all-you-can-eat or all-day breakfast, McPick 2. They're even doing a special promotion in Missouri, all-you-can-eat fries. And one of my favorites, they're bringing back the brat in 125 Milwaukee stores. McDonald's right now is trading around $126 a share. That is positive. And Scott, I'm heading to Milwaukee in a couple of weeks, so might have to try the brats there.
I think you should. That's the town for them, isn't it?
Definitely.
All right. Jeff, thank you so much. Let's get a check now on our Ospreys. John is back, and we've been watching our birds and,
yes,
and our baby just get bigger by the day.
Yeah, we were talking earlier before the broadcast started that really is beginning to look more like a predator raptor than just a cute little birdie chick. You know, it's just, yeah, getting the curved beak now, and the eyes seem to be focusing on objects. And, you know, it's not going to be too long before baby leaves home.
I know. And
don't
then
you think?
Learns the art of catching fish, because
that's right,
these birds are the best at that.
The best. As I understand it, they only miss 1 in 4 times, which is an amazing,
wow,
amazing fishing record, you know?
Uh-oh.
So, what?
I saw the...
Oh, yes?
The
is that it?
I'm
there
waiting.
We go. Okay. Oh. Lucky folks at home, you don't get to see that every day.
And it missed the camera, which is huge.
They did. Okay. Live TV. You can't beat that.
And how about a segue now to Judy Gallagher? There are many great locations to grab a bite to eat around the Suncoast. One of those locations at the mall at University Town Center is a great pit stop when you need a break from shopping. ABC 7 Culinary Director Judy Gallagher is live today at Yo Sushi. And what a fun place to eat, Judy.
Scott, you know where it really is, and it's fun, it's vibrant, it's very healthy, and it gives you great options. We're going to find out about their new menu that's coming out May 3rd. Japanese street food is the focus, and we are talking a company that is rich in culture, Japanese-style cooking, but also sustainability. So you're going to get to meet the executive chef, you're going to meet the general manager, Diego, who we love. You've seen them on ABC before, and we're going to get the new flavors of Japanese street food. Stay with me throughout the hour at the UTC Mall at Yo Sushi, and you will see what's fresh and fun.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
Since 1928, Karastan has been setting the standard in carpets and rugs, producing non-allergenic wools that won't promote the growth of bacteria or dust mites like other carpets will. Karastan wools actively remove contaminants from the indoor air, making your home healthier. And there are many colors and patterns and textures to choose from. Come see for yourself.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Manasota Flooring.
At Sunset Subaru, it's all about getting more for your money. More years, more miles, more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. And right now, you can lease the most award-winning small SUV on the planet, a new 2016 Subaru Forester, for just $229 a month, complimentary maintenance included, at the new redesigned Sunset Subaru dealership in Sarasota. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC 7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
Temperature outside is a warm 82 degrees. Dew point now in the 60s, and we have a south wind at 15. We'll watch that south wind switch even further to the southwest as we head into the remainder of the afternoon. We started off with a northeast wind, then it went to southeast. Now we're at south, so we're going to work our way around the clock here on this frontal passage. 81 degrees in Wachula, Mayaca at 83, 83 in Arcadia, 82 in Northport, 83 in Punta Gorda. Closer to the coastline, it's a little bit cooler, especially on south-facing beaches, 82 Sarasota, 80 in Venice, 79 in Inglewood, 82 in Bradenton and Parrish, and 75 degrees Longboat Key. Across the entire area, we have no radar echoes yet, but we're seeing some showers trying to make their way a little bit closer to the shoreline. As soon as that wind shifts southwest, I think the progression closer to shore will be a little bit faster. You'll notice the tendency still is for these to kind of dissipate as they get closer. And frankly, this is what we call a composite radar picture. So it takes a pictures of all the radar beams from the surface all the way to the top. Anyway, you're getting a whole picture of all the scans of the radar, including the very tippy top. And that's what these echoes are, way out in front of the main cell. I don't think that's even reaching the ground. That's falling through the air and evaporating on the way down. So we'll wait for the system to get a little bit closer, and maybe by about 3, 4 o'clock, we might see some of those showers work their way a little closer to shore. But it's going to be inland along the sea breeze front where the showers will start to pop up because of the tremendous amount of humidity. Then after that, probably around 7 o'clock or so, maybe some of this rain shower activity might get a little closer to the coastline and give coastal residents another little shot at some rain showers this afternoon. There are some lightning pops associated with some of these storms. Some of them are fairly significant. To the further north you go, the more the lightning is apparent. It is possible that we'll get a thunderstorm around here as well. In fact, as these sea breeze storms begin to form and move inland, could get some small hail. There's cold enough air upstairs to allow for that. We have a frontal boundary that stretches really all the way up around a low pressure area moving off into the north and to the east. And that low pressure area and frontal boundary is what's producing the cloud cover that you see here in the center part and northern parts of the Gulf waters. That's gradually going to get closer to us, and it's going to bring us that chance of rain. But it's also going to bring us some delightful weekend weather. Here's what's going to happen. Our southerly wind flow, which we're getting right now, and the frontal boundary, which will lose some of its energy the further south it sinks as it becomes more east-west as opposed to north-south, that front will eventually twist our winds around to the southwest. And once it's past us tomorrow morning, high pressure will build in. Then our winds will swing around to the northwest, and that'll draw down some slightly drier air. Again, at this time of year, these are not particularly powerful or effective fronts. So they kind of limp through and bring just the kind of kicker necessary to help produce an extra shower or two. More importantly, they twist our winds around from the east to the southwest and bring the higher humidity our way. Saturday clearing, and that clearing should last right straight through the weekend. Showers build along the sea breeze front initially, then a few showers come our way later in the evening with the main cold front passage, and then tomorrow it all clears out and we are left with a beautiful weekend. Forecast looks like this for you boaters. Watch for those shifting winds and maybe a thunderstorm or two out in Gulf waters. We'll have a 2-foot sea and a light chop, but it's the thunderstorms you'll have to dodge. And then over the next several days, you know, temperatures remain pretty flat around the 80-degree mark. But the rain shower chances go away after today. Scott?
John, thank you. Researchers worry one of the most prescribed medications in the world may come with a risk. Drugs known as PPIs, proton pump inhibitors, are used for those with ulcers, heartburn, and acid reflux. New research published in the Journal of the American Society of Nephrology suggests a link between PPIs and a dramatic increase in the risk of kidney disease and kidney failure. It found the risk of kidney failure was 96% higher in patients taking PPIs than it was in patients taking a PPI alternative. Now, the authors are quick to point out that it's just an observational link, and there's no evidence that the PPIs cause the increased risk. Doctors say there are three ways our brains get rewarded and make us feel good. The first is the most obvious, such as maybe eating an ice cream cone or taking a warm bath. The second way is by accomplishing something, whether it's a project or a difficult task, or even just building something. The third way is when you do something good for someone else or for the betterment of many. Doctors say the key to feeling truly rewarded is to be able to balance your life to where you are able to get all three.
You feel like I'm being a good person, I'm being a contributory member to society, I'm on my way to heaven, whatever the heck it is. And there is sort of a little bit of a selfish motive that, but not entirely. I mean, you are genuinely doing something nice for somebody.
Also, feeling rewarded helps us keep negative thoughts away from ourselves and from others. When we come back, we'll meet a friend that needs a loving home, and we'll check back in with Chef Judy at Yo Sushi. Stay with us.
On Animal Outtakes, every week, it's a new animal adventure. This week on Animal Outtakes, furry, fast, and full of energy.
True puppy love.
Puppy love.
We're checking out some unique breeds and learning what makes them so special. Watch Animal Outtakes this weekend on ABC 7.
The all-new MySuncoast.com. Just another way, we're here for you.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. So the next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America.
And who knew our pricing was so good?
G. Fried, Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
Sunset Fiat is Italian style. Sunset Fiat is fashion forward. Come see the all-new Fiat collection at Sunset Fiat with new 2015 Fiat 500s priced from $12,999. Sunset Fiat is cool and sexy with freedom to move and room to evolve. Visit Sunset Fiat in Sarasota or shop online at fiatusaofsarasota.com.
It's time again to meet a pet that is in need of a loving home. John is with the founder of Dante's Den and host of Animal Outtakes, Marsha Panucci. Hey, guys.
Hi. One of my favorite dog breeds ever, a Basset. Oh, they're so wonderful.
And he is a purebred, John. He is a 7.5-year-old dog. His family was unable to take care of him at this point. They ran into a little hard times. So here is Joey, and Joey is an absolute delight. You can see his markings are almost perfect. He's a singer. That should interest you.
I've heard him sing.
Yes,
Basso
yes.
Profondo.
Yes, he does. Yes, yes, yes. His rendition of How Much Is That Doggy in the Window is one of the best. And he is a happy dog. He loves to be your couch partner. He runs around, so you can see he is not overweight. He's very, very svelte. And he loves to ride in cars.
I would imagine at seven, too, he's probably house trained, right?
Very much house trained.
Yeah.
And
probably,
you know,
knows some interior manners as well.
Yes.
Some rules,
yeah. We've noticed that he doesn't sit as well as we would like, but then again, look at the anatomy of the dog, so maybe that's not possible.
But he is just a
wonderful love. He is a very healthy dog, as best as we know it today. He came in healthy, and so he remains healthy with us.
And what is the Dante Den's adoption procedure?
Well, the adoption procedure is that you fill out an application. We review that application, and then we do make a house visit. If we don't make a pre-house and pre-adoption visit, and we go on our instincts that you'll be a wonderful parent, we always find a way to invite ourselves for coffee after they're adopted.
Of course. Well, that's a smart thing to do.
Yes.
You've got to be sure.
Absolutely.
You good those eyes. And what is the adoption fee?
We have a contribution because, as you know, we are a private foundation, so we ask for a contribution of $275. By no means does that cover the care of the dog as they are with us. Yes, I know. He knows I have that treat in my hand. Yes, so he's singing for his treat. And as you know, Dante's Den has no cages. They live in rooms, air-conditioned rooms. They swim in our swimming pool. And one of the many comments that we get when people take a tour is, "My goodness, I've never seen so many happy dogs." Now, take a look at Joey. He is a happy, adjusted dog. We'd love to keep all of the dogs at Dante's Den, but we do know that they need forever couches, as we say. So he's looking for a home. We will be so happy to find him a good one.
Take a good look at that face. That is a face that launched 1,000 ships. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous animal. Give him a call, Dante's Den. Marcia, thanks for bringing in such a lovely adoptable babe.
And Joey, thanks you.
Oh, what a sweetheart.